This is how the protesters have responded to a Hong Kong government decision to break off talks with the demonstrators on Thursday. They called for a rally, tried to make a popular show of force to put pressure on the Hong Kong government in negotiations, again, that have stalled. Now, the Hong Kong government, the number two official, said that the talks were broken off because the grounds for constructive dialogue had been seriously undermined. So we have a situation where thousands of people are out here, but the character of the demonstration in downtown Hong Kong has changed somewhat. There is now a stage, there are now speakers, there are screens now. The crowd doesn't seem to be made up as much of 18 to 22-year-old students. It's much more mixed, and we're not seeing quite the surging grassroots numbers of people that we saw in the first week of October, a much more spontaneous gathering of people who were outraged at the use of tear gas by riot police against unarmed student demonstrators. The argument, of course, is over democracy, over projected elections for this former British colony in the year 2017. The people here say they want more free and fair elections. They don't want Beijing to have the power to vet and select candidates for that election. And the government here has said it is simply not in a position to negotiate on these terms, on these rules for the election. So it's really a test of will. And the Hong Kong government clearly not willing to use force right now to try to break up this sit-in and others in downtown Hong Kong, because it has blown up. It's been a public relations problem for the government in the past. And meanwhile, the demonstrators risk alienating parts of Hong Kong society who are increasingly inconvenienced by the sit-in, that snarling traffic in parts of this financial hub. Ivan Watson, CNN, Hong Kong.